Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Crack Economics and Statistics. This is Professor Atman Shah. I teach economics at St. Xavier's College, Ahmedabad, India. In this video, I'm going to discuss the idea of nominal and ordinal data and what is the difference between these two. To find more videos on SPSS, statistics and economics, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Let's begin with the idea of level of measurement. Level of measurement is how we measure the variable, and it is also known as scale of measurement. So for example, we have variable gender. Now how we measure this variable called gender when we analyze the data? Suppose we have income, satisfaction level, temperature, weight, height, savings, consumption expenditure, opinion about public policy. So how we measure the variable is very important when we do the statistical analysis. Why this measurement of variable is very important? The selection of the statistical tool depends on the nature of the data. Let's understand it with the help of example. Karl-Pearson's correlation coefficient is used find the association between two variables when we have the continuous data. So both the variables are continuous. On the other hand, we use chi-square test to find the association between two nominal data. So both these tests, the Karl-Pearson's correlation coefficient test and this chi-square test, both are used to find the association, the relationship between two variables. But that depends, the selection of this test depends on the nature of the data. So if we have nominal data, we go for chi-square test. If both the variables are continuous, then we go for Karl-Pearson's correlation coefficient. So the selection of the statistical tool, the selection of the statistical test depends on the nature of the data, and that is why the consideration of the level of measurement is very important when we do the analysis. Now, Stanley Stephen Smith in 1946 developed the four measurements in his article on the theory of scale of measurement. The first is nominal. First level of measurement is nominal. Second is ordinal. Third is interval. And fourth is ratio. In this video, we are going to discuss this to a level of measurement, nominal and ordinal. The nominal and ordinal, both the data are categorical data. These two are categorical data. So we give codes to each and every category of the nominal or ordinal variable. So we define the categories in number. We give codes numerically. Now let's understand the idea of nominal data. Nominal data is used to give labels, names to the categories. And labeling does not have any numerical value. When we assign the code to the nominal variable, that labeling, that code does not have any numerical value. And codes are mutually exclusive, which means that we cannot give the same code to more than one categories. Suppose we have variable sex and we assign one to male and two to female. So here we have this variable called sex. That variable has two categories, male and female. We assign a numerical value one to male and two to female. But this value does not have, this code does not have any numerical value, any numerical importance. So here two does not mean that it is greater than one. This is just a label. So we can also assign one to female and two to male. So order doesn't matter. And this code, suppose we have assigned one to male, then the same code cannot be assigned to female. So we cannot assign one to male and one to female, or two to male and two to female. So the codes are mutually exclusive. And order of the code, order of the coins, order of the label does not matter at all. So you can see that here we have assigned 1 to male and 2 to female. We can also assign 1 to female and 2 to male. So your order does not matter at all, because the labels, the points, does not have any numerical value. Let's take another example. Suppose we have type of residence. Our variable is type of residence. We can assign 1 to rural, 2 to semi-urban, and 3 to urban. Again, this variable called type of residence has three categories: rural, semi-urban, urban. So I have assigned 1 to rural, 2 to semi-urban, and 3 to urban. But again, we can assign 1 to urban, 2 to rural, and 3 to semi-urban, because order doesn't matter and points do not have any numerical importance, any numerical value. A nominal variable which has only two categories is known as dichotomous or binary variable. A nominal variable which has only two categories, for example sex, two categories, male and female, then sex is a nominal variable, but it is known as dichotomous variable, a binary variable, because this variable has only two categories. Suppose we have type of residence, and in that variable we have only two categories, rural and urban, and type of residence is also a dichotomous variable. Suppose we have the variable income, low income, high income group. So again, level of income becomes a dichotomous variable, because that variable has only two categories. So a nominal variable with only two categories is known as dichotomous or binary variable. Now let's understand the idea of ordinal data. Here the order of the variable is very important. In nominal data, we have seen that order doesn't matter, but in ordinal data, order matters. Order is very important when we assign the codes to each and every category. Basically, the ordinal data is used to depict, to explain the level of happiness, pain, satisfaction, whether you are likely to recommend the service of the company or not. So you are very likely, neutral, very unlikely, or unlikely. Right, so order is very important, and it is used to explain, to depict the level of pain or gain, happiness, satisfaction, etc. So it contains the information about the rank. Let's understand it with the help of example. Suppose a firm has collected the data on the consumer's satisfaction about the services it provides. So one is assigned to highly satisfied, consumers are highly satisfied. Code 2 is assigned to satisfied category. 3 is assigned to neutral. 4 is assigned to dissatisfied. And 5 is assigned to highly dissatisfied. So here we have this 5 categories. And what is our variable? Level of satisfaction. Our variable is level of satisfaction. So here order is very important. You cannot change the order, because if you change the orders of the categories, the meaning changes. While in nominal data, if we change the order, then meaning does not change. So the distance between the two points in ordinal data is not meaningful. Please mind well that the distance between 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4, 4 and 5, or 1 and 5 is not meaningful. So suppose I am highly satisfied and you are neutral. So one is assigned to me and three is assigned to you. And third person is satisfied. So two is assigned to that third person. Now we cannot identify that how much more satisfied I am than that third person or you. So how much one consumer is more satisfied than other cannot be known, because the distance between these two categories is not meaningful. It only says that I am more satisfied than you. But what is the magnitude of the distance? That cannot be known. What is the magnitude of the difference between two categories? Cannot be known. Right? Now, what is the difference between these two? Let's understand the difference very quickly. Both are categorical data. In nominal data, order doesn't matter. In ordinal data, order is very important. Order matters. Now, which mathematical operations can be used when we have nominal data? In nominal data, we can only use equal to or not equal to. Equal to or not equal to. So whether one is equal to male or not equal to male. Whether two is equal to female or not equal to female. Whether one is equal to rural or not. No other mathematical operations can be used when we have the nominal data. In ordinal data, we can use greater than and less than in addition to the equal to and non-equal to. So here we can use whether one is greater than two or two is greater than one, right? Because order matters. So this is the idea of nominal and ordinal data. If you find this video useful, kindly share it with others and also subscribe to my YouTube channel, Crack Economics and Statistics. Thank you.